It's like gentle in my head. All right, we're back.
Welcome back.
We're back with another episode. Today is a special episode. It's the 100th episode, and we just wanted to make it a little bit more special by recording it and having some drinks, you know? We just want to go ahead and get right into it. We got a couple questions from some of our fans. The first question is from Beery. She said, what is our love language? So we'll go ahead and start with you, Jason. I know we were already talking about it, but go ahead. You said you, the five love languages is quality time, words of affirmation, acts of service, physical touch, and receiving gifts or gifts in general. So what do you think your love is? How do you like to receive it, and how do you like to give it?
Okay, so receiving, I used
to... Jason's like, eh?
Nah, so receiving, I used to be more of the words of affirmation.
Okay.
You know, I used to like to be told, like, I love you, or just, you know, stuff like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think I've moved more, I've grown more, you know, I've got older, just understood love a little bit different. So I feel like I'm at this point, I'm still kind of words of affirmation, but I'm also quality time, you know?
Okay.
And that's as far as receiving, giving love, it's more of a gifts. I like to give gifts. I feel like giving is a kind of a mixture of all. I don't think I can have, I mean, is it normal to have all a bunch of different?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, a bunch of different languages. You can have a bunch of them.
How do you feel most comfortable though? Like showing your love? How do you show your love? Is it like words of affirmation? Like you tell your partner how much you love them, like what you like about them, all this stuff?
Well, I don't know how sure what category would this fall into as much of doing like a service,
you know, service,
acts of service. Oh well, yeah, duh. So I'm more of an acts of service, I think, as far as giving. Like I tend to, you know, when someone asks for help or something, I'm just real helpful. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I like to, you know, lend a hand or if you know
your favors.
Yeah, I'm hands-on, and it's not because it's like a favor, but it's because obviously because I care about that person that I'm helping or not. So I think giving is acts of service.
I think a lot of guys are like that. I think especially Mexican dads, I feel like a lot of times, especially, you know, Mexican dads growing up, they're not very like emotional and stuff, and so like they'll do stuff for you. And that's how they show their way of like
that's caring.
Because, you know, we grow up in like that culture where it's like Mexican dads got to be tough and they don't like cry.
Mexican guys in general.
Yeah. It's like that.
It's hard for them to show like their emotions or show their, you know, their feelings.
Mm-hmm.
So the way that they show it is like that. Either acts of service or like, that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Or gifts.
What's yours?
So I know we haven't talked about it. I think... I like to receive it with quality time. I'm a quality time person. I like spending quality time with people, and it doesn't really matter like what we do. It just like just as long as we get to like spend time, that would be like my way of receiving it. My way of giving, believe it or not, I want to say it's physical touch, but it's weird. So like I noticed this with like family and friends. Like a lot of times I'm not very like physical. I'm not like oh, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I noticed this like with my girlfriend, I'm very like physical.
Uh-oh.
Like yeah. Uh-oh. Yeah, like I like holding hands, I like hugs, I like it makes me more like sensitive or more vulnerable.
More
yeah, you know what I mean? And I like it. I like it a lot, and that's kind of how but I've also noticed, so I'm also really close to with gifts like how you are.
Mm-hmm.
And I never was like a gift person. Like I know we talked about this before. Like I'm not really like that gift person. Like I like giving stuff to people because I personally think I'm not really good at gifts. But I've noticed that like in my relationship, I like to gift stuff. Like I just like to do little things, like write little notes, write little gifts, like little thoughtful things. And I like doing that. And I know it makes them feel really good, and it makes me feel really good. So that's also really up there too. So I don't know. It's one of those two things.
Yeah,
physical touch or physical touch and quality time and gifts. I'd say those. But
receiving is physical touch and quality time.
Yeah, for sure. Like, and those go really well hand in hand because quality time, they're already there, and they might as well just like give you a hug, you know, give you a little kiss, man. You know,
you can stop there.
Yeah, pause.
Yeah. So, what about you, Julio?
Okay, so receiving for sure.
I was gonna say, who's like, I want to fuck.
No, I think okay. Let Okay, I was gonna guess yours, but I already know yours. Heard it. So, okay, yeah.
Okay, go ahead and guess.
So I think you're very touchy. You're very hands on. Like,
yeah, yeah. Oh yeah. That's
okay, it. But I'm just gonna go there. Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead.
That's it.
Okay, yeah, yeah, I don't want to answer yours. For...
Okay. Yeah, I've never been big of a big gift kind of person. Even for like my birthday, when like my family would always ask me, like even since I was like a little kid, they were like, "What do you want for your birthday?" I was like, "Eh, whatever." Like, I never really cared about gifts much. I appreciate them, but it's never been my thing. I think the way like I feel, like I actually feel, is definitely like that, like physically or quality time. Like if somebody's like, "Oh, let's just hang out," I love it, man. Like you with anybody, like my significant other, like my friends, like if they're like inviting me to go out to eat, even just to go out to eat, I love it. You know, like go out for a hike or let's go to the gym, like do things like that. That's how I like it. That's how I feel the love. To give it, for sure, for me, I guess, like Luis said, it's just, maybe it's a guy thing. But it's definitely, like, gifts and like, acts of service. Like, the way I like to show, like, the love to, like, my family members or, like, my fiance, you know, it's, like, doing things for her. Like, I don't know, like, changing her oil. Like, things like that, you know? Like a service for her. Like, do something for her. And I feel like that's how I show her that I care about her, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what were you gonna ask?
It was just off topic. We were talking about the changing the oil. Have you seen those videos where they're like, "Oh yeah, I changed my oil. They charged me like $500 or something." Yeah, yeah. And they're like, $500 bucks to change your oil."
Yeah,
I feel like this happened back in the day though.
I feel like to me, a lot of people would be getting bamboozled or whatever. But
anyway, yeah, that's a whole thing. That's a love language. I think we've talked about it before.
I think so. Honestly, mm-hmm. I think that was a very good question, Barry. And yeah, we did. I honestly feel like the love languages, before we change to the next topic, love languages are very important. Like, you have to know what your, especially when in relationships, like, you got to know what your love language is to be able to be compatible or like, to be able to, like, connect.
I think it's a great conversation, like, whenever you're meeting somebody.
Yeah.
Like, maybe not right off, but, like, you know, once you're, like, getting, like, with somebody.
A little bit
like,
more serious,
like, just have that conversation, like, you know.
Yeah, but I don't think I would necessarily base the entire future of a relationship
based on the beginning of that.
But I think, because these emotions, they change, bro. Like I said, you know, I was one way at some point, and then I've kind of
but you're also at a different stage of your life now. You're married now.
Yeah, but I mean,
yeah, it changes.
It doesn't really matter. But it changes. You know what I mean? But it's good to know. It is good to know. I wouldn't say like. I mean, yeah, I'm. That's right. You know, go ahead and if you meet somebody, eventually, you guys ask each other that question, but I wouldn't make a decision based on their answer at that point.
No,
you know? Because it's always able to change.
No, you would make a decision based on that.
No, not me. I'm just saying people. Like, I don't want to give that message to anybody. You know,
someone might. If I'm talking to somebody, and they're like how I show my love uh-huh. is through gifts. I'm like. I don't give a damn about it.
Yes. Oh,
you know, like, then yeah. It could affect it.
I mean, it could.
I'm just saying, give it a chance. No, this is the same topic.
Oh, okay, go ahead.
What I was gonna say is that a lot of times people do get discouraged and they'd be like, okay, well, that's not my love language, and they don't want to do it. Like, before you start thinking like that, like, you have to think about, especially in relationships, like, you got to think about your other partner and be like, okay, even though they like gifts and you're not a gift person, like. And they love gifts. Like, you should try to actually, like, put yourself out there and actually, like, try to give them gifts, even though it doesn't affect you at all, but knowing that it would affect them in so many ways.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
That scared the fuck out of me.
That's what I was going to say. Squirt. I was going to say, like, for example, like, you're meeting somebody and you ask
Well, let's just say you're already in a relationship.
Let's just say somebody.
Because all of us are already.
Let's just say me and Jason are meeting right now.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Like, hey, Jason, bro. Like, you know, like, hey, what's your love language, bro?
Jesus, like, I ain't gay.
You're like gifts.
Gifts.
I like that example.
Man, that's not really how I show my love, but you know, I like Jason. He's a cutie. Yeah. You know what?
Bro, you're not. Anyhow,
I'm like, you know, like, okay, I don't, maybe that's not my love language, that's not how I show it, but I like this other person. I really like this other person. I want to make it work. Now it's really good information to know. Like, is I'm glad I know. So now I'm gonna go out of my way, and maybe I do. I like to do words of affirmation, but instead of that, I'm just gonna shift it more towards gifts because that's what she likes or the other person likes. So that's what I'm saying. It's a good it's a good conversation to have, so you can know the other person, and that way you know how to make them feel loved.
Yep. And then also,
and you would go the extra mile if you really like this person. If you're selfish and you're like, well, that's not how I show my love. Like, next, like. All right,
but that you won't go far.
Mm. Yeah, then that wasn't for you.
Not only that, though, once you do that and they reciprocate the same energy and then they give you that love language that you are, then, like, you feel it. And then, like, it's a win-win,
you know?
But both people have to try, you know. That's true. That's a really good question. Very appreciate you for asking. We need to get you back on the show again. All right, next question. Mark, what would you do if fear was not a factor and you could not fail?
Ooh, that's a good question.
A lot of things. I mean, I think a lot of people base, you know, the future of their life off of at what point would it go wrong? So it's a fear of something. So if that wasn't a factor, I mean, dude, I think I'd do a lot of different stuff.
I
feel like a lot of people would go after their dreams. Mm-hmm.
Well, because at that point, everyone's afraid of failing. Everyone is afraid of failing. I think.
A little bit, yeah.
I think
just because they're scared of the unknown. Yeah. They don't know what's going to happen.
So, you know, without that fear, I think everybody would go for a lot of their dreams.
Yep. yeah, because it was definitely a game changer.
It is.
It's definitely a game changer. You know, like, if, for example, if you, for many reasons, it could be financially, it could be, like, emotionally, it could be, example, financially, let's say that what your dream is, maybe start a business, whatever it is. You're like, oh, damn, but I got to invest all this, and I'm not going to have enough money for this. Like, what if it doesn't work out, then I'm going to be broke. But if you didn't have that fear, you would just go for it. And maybe, you know, maybe it will work.
Right.
What was the question again?
Fear was not a factor, and you could not fail.
What
would you do? Could you do?
Well, that somebody, more people would probably start their own business. Right. Go after their dreams, I think.
Well, but here's the thing, though. Here's the thing about failure is in life, you're going to get told no a lot.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. People are going to tell you no. They're going to... No. Yeah, they will. The people are going to tell you no a lot. They're going to treat you like shit. It's not every
it's
day.
It's inevitable.
It's inevitable. Yeah, you're going to face it a lot of times.
Yeah, a lot of times in life. Yeah,
and
we know.
And like, you just have to, like,
video gamers.
Just know that, like, you're going to get told no, but eventually you're going to get told yes. And once you get told yes, you know, your life is going to, it could take off.
Yeah.
You know, so I guess just, you really, really don't need to be afraid to fail. Everyone fails. Mm-hmm. Bill Gates failed. Mm-hmm. Amazon guy failed. Everybody failed, bro. Mm-hmm. At some point, Elon was Jeff.
Jeff Bezos.
Okay, the richest guy in the world.
Elon Musk. Amazon, he failed. Bro. You know,
Baldy. It was straight Baldy.
Baldy. Everybody fails, bro. So I mean, Baldy, I just.
I agree.
I don't know. Yeah. You know? Just don't look at it like that.
Yeah.
Try not to.
But don't let fear. Like, another thing I was saying, financially, also, like, maybe emotionally, the way, like, maybe like starting a podcast or something public.
Yeah.
Maybe you're afraid of, like, oh, what are people going to say? Like, what if they, like,
fuck
say
em.
Mean things? And, like,
what if all right, like, for instance, mean? Dave Chappelle, bro. You know, Dave Chappelle, he
got a lot of hate.
He gets a lot of hate, but he don't care because, I mean, he's staying true to himself. You know, like, you got to stay true to yourself, too, as far as, like, you're saying, like, afraid to care about what people say or what they're going to say.
Yeah, because I think we're always going to get hate. Like, mm-hmm. not, like, from everybody, but people are always not going to agree with the same things. No. So, like... You might as well just do what you want to do.
But yeah.
That's a good question.
Without fear, you definitely put more people to be more happy in general. But yeah. Go ahead.
That's a really good question, Mark. Thank you for asking that. Next question, buddy. By Melissa. Most iconic episode and y'all's favorite thing about the experience since you started episode one.
Okay, so we are on the 100th episode.
So that's we a have lot 100 episodes.
79 other episodes.
I'm going to be honest. I have to look through and remember each and every one. I remember
it
a lot.
It must not be that iconic. We can't remember.
Not like,
well, what's the
every
one
single one?
Well, what's the
no,
okay?
The one that.
Comes out. Oh, I can. Yeah, the most
iconic. What sticks out? What episode stuck out with you
right now?
The cops. I don't know why.
Yeah.
That
I
one
really
keeps
like
sticking
one.
Out.
I really
the
like
cops
that
episode.
One. I think it was.
But what stuck with you though? That stuck with him. What stuck with
well,
you?
I really
it
like
can't
that
be,
one because
I mean it probably be the same, but.
I really like that one just because it was, I think it was like a great conversation.
Uh-huh.
Like we kept asking the right questions. Like it was a good episode in general.
Mm-hmm.
For that reason, I think it is iconic. I think the most iconic, maybe the first one.
I was gonna say the first one.
Because I started it off. Yeah, you know,
like, damn, that's crazy. I didn't look at the first one. I can see it now the way y'all look at it. Well,
you didn't. You took that first one off, bro.
I was not even on air.
It's gone.
Is it still in archives?
Every episode's gone. It's you
is
know,
it still in archives, or did you delete it?
I didn't. I don't know what the fuck I did. Gosh, I didn't mean to delete it permanently. It just
will never get that back.
Another one that was also very iconic for me, and it has really nothing to do with the episode itself, but it's the way that people treated it, was the David Dobrik one. That David Dobrik one went viral, and it's like the most watched.
I guess that's
episode.
Because that's why.
It's like
the clout it got.
And so it got a lot of clout. And so for me, I think that was like very iconic, because like we were making episodes up to that point, and none of them were like going that hard, like with that many people.
Yeah.
And just out of nowhere, it just started like, it just started growing. Like, it's just people started listening like from all over the place. And I honestly felt like that felt cool. Like, it felt like we could actually make something that people will actually like, that
we'll listen to.
So it honestly, it gave me more of like, encouragement or an opportunity, or it gave me more of confidence to see, be like, okay, we can keep going.
What about the one you did with your grandparents?
That one was also one of my very, that one actually is probably one of my favorite ones. It's top three for sure. My grandparents, because that one was something very, I guess it's, for me, it's more personal, and maybe, but at the same time, it's very relatable with people too. Like, people can relate with their grandparents and stuff like that. And it was really cool, 'cause like, it's not every day that you get to have your grandparents on the podcast, and then they get to like talk about their life experiences and how they grew up. It's a really, really good show, episode. You guys need to watch it if you haven't. It's on YouTube. You can watch a whole video on it. But I honestly feel like that was one of like my favorite ones, actually.
I think another iconic one. I don't remember which episode it was, but I think it's the one where we were arguing with Jason about like the kids that wanted to be professional video gamers.
Yeah, it's a video game episode.
Because it was like, we were just arguing the whole time.
Oh, dude, there's a lot of episodes.
I know.
I remember that one. Like, we got heated, bro.
Yeah,
Jason was like, I don't give a fuck.
That one, the abortion episode,
it was probably the same one. And that one was, not only did it get heated with us, but even with the people listening, they were like, damn, like I was there, man. Yeah, they were feeling heated too, man.
Hey, but
I mean, we can have some arguments.
Surprisingly enough, cool enough is like, there was people on both sides. There's people backing up Jason.
Bro, I don't mind, bro. I'll fight a battle on solo, you know?
Yeah. Jason's like, I'll take on
your army, dog. I guess, you know? We out here.
Next question.
That was a really good question.
It was two questions to that one. What have we learned?
And the most iconic episode and the favorite thing about the experience since episode one.
What's your favorite thing about the experience? I think my favorite is just...
That's a really good question.
It's just the engagement that we've had with different people. We've had a lot of engagement from all over the world. You know, we've had people from Australia, from
Canada.
Remember
my bro, yeah. Miguel, if he's still listening, he was going to come by, remember?
His name was Miguel?
Just the engagement.
I thought that one guy from Arizona.
That's a great experience.
I don't know, maybe. And just seeing
how far we've come since, you know, episode one, with all the merch that we've given out, the gifts that we've given out, the merch that we've sold and stuff. I mean, that's a great experience, you know? Yeah. We've really come a long ways.
I think it's a really good experience. I think the favorite thing about all this, for me, it's more of like being able to just people to have a platform where people can like just listen to us. I think because, especially me, like I'm like the way that I am on video, on episode, like this is how I am, like in general.
No, it's not.
Yeah. And like, so like, I guess like it feels really good that I can like just be myself, and then people actually like support that. Like, maybe they don't support everything that we all like believe in, because we obviously are going to have our differences, but like, it 100%. Feels really, really good to like be able to like have this and then just talk about stuff and then just have fun with it. Like, we don't have to be serious all the time. Like, I don't like being serious anyways. Like, I don't like being serious all the time. Like, to me, that just seems kind of like,
yeah, we do. We do tend to, when we're on here, we like to goof off.
We're serious. Yeah, we're very serious.
Yeah, we get serious. Yeah. But another thing that I was gonna say is also the experience of having a bunch of different guests. You know, we've had a lot of, we've had quite a few.
That's true, yeah. It's fun, like, listening to different people here. Which, that was the original thing that was, or at least for me, that was the original thing I wanted
to do. It was, because me and Julio wanted to do something before the podcast. It was, we wanted to make, like, videos. Oh, yeah. It was kind of like Humans of New York on Instagram, if you guys don't know what that is. It's, like, a guy that just roams New York and just, like, interviews people. And just pretty much interviews people about their lives or anything interesting or bad or whatever. And that's kind of how we wanted to start. We ended up interviewing one person in Palo Mountain. Shout out to Kyle. And he's a good guy. And so we ended up, like, doing all that. And then, long story short, that's kind of how it shifted into a podcast. I'm not sure what really made us, like, really just jump into it, because I don't think we had anything planned. We didn't really know.
I'll tell you what it was.
What?
It was me, dog.
hey, y'all didn't go through with it until I was let's go. Y'all stepped to the edge, but y'all didn't jump until I was like, yo, let's go.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
Who's got a perfect attendance? Not true. Anyways.
Meeting with the people is a good one.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Right, so I think
the guess is.
Yeah, I think my best experience, and I'm about to get emotional here, guys, and put some sad music behind this, bro.
Okay.
Cue the violin.
Yeah, play the violin music. I think my favorite experience about all this is, one, obviously, it's a new experience, like doing new things, like getting to come out and record, and like knowing that a lot of people are listening to us, you know, weekly. But the best thing, I think, is like just getting to meet with you guys, you know, like,
that's a way better answer than mine, bro.
Like, you know, like, we all have our lives. We all got our lives going on.
I should have said that.
And yeah. I see some of my friends. You know, because they're my friends, but like, but as we get older, like, we stop seeing a lot of people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this has been a great opportunity for me, like, you know, just for me to, like, keep in touch with you guys. Mm-hmm. And, like, mm-hmm. you know, you guys are, like, two of my favorite people, like, ever. And it's cool, like, seeing y'all, like, and getting to talk to y'all and, like, getting to do all this with y'all and, like, getting to plan all this stuff and, like, do all this thing. So, yeah, I mean, this is what I like the most about this. Like, I get to hang out with my friends and, like, do something fun.
Yeah, bro. That's a great answer.
It's good.
It's weird because, like, we kind of all think about that same stuff, and it's good that we able to talk about all of it. Like, kind of go a full circle in a way. Mm-hmm. Like, all these things, honestly, is what make us, like, truly appreciate being able to have a podcast.
Yeah, because if I was doing this with, like, somebody that
I don't think you would have started anyway, though.
I wouldn't have started anyway. Yeah, you wouldn't have started. If somebody would have invited me and, like, hey, man, let's do this podcast, I would have been like, okay, let's do it. I don't think I would have lasted, like, maybe 10, 15 episodes, you know? Like, hey, man, I got other things going on. But since, like, it's y'all, like, you know.
But isn't that weird?
Well, you know, the thing is, too, we've not been afraid. Like, when we've been slacking, we've been slacking. We'll crap on each other. Okay. We'll be like, hey, bro, we need to get our crap together.
But wait,
let Jason finish.
I was just saying, like, that's the thing, too, is, like you said, I can't remember what you said, but what you just said a minute ago, but we've not been afraid to, like, if somebody's been slacking, or we know we've all been slacking, we would just kind of go ahead and say it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Like, we just kind of,
that's push. What true friends are for, though. Like, you're not gonna let your friends keep doing something that they shouldn't be doing or whatever, and not say anything. Like, you gotta be there, and you gotta hold them accountable for whatever they do. I was gonna say something. What you were saying is that how I feel like. I forgot what I was gonna say. What were you gonna say? You go ahead.
What I was gonna say is, like, another really important thing that we're all friends and that we're, like, close. And it's because, like, we can have those heated arguments, and literally as soon as we stop recording, we can just laugh it off.
Yeah,
like, we don't carry that, you know. We don't carry that with us, and, like, man, fucking Jason,
fuck that guy, man.
I am the Republican.
Oh, another thing I was going to say, now I remember what I was going to say. Isn't it weird that, like, how we ended up, like, doing all this? Because, like, we all kind of met through working here.
I mean,
well, y'all,
like, I mean, I didn't really talk to you until you worked here.
Yeah.
And I knew Jason before.
I think we're just, like, me and you really not. We haven't, we didn't really meet him until he started working here.
Yeah.
Well, I met you before. I knew you before.
Yeah, but I didn't really talk to you.
We just knew each other. But when we were here, I hung out with him a lot more than I hung out with you. Maybe it was a little bit both. No, that's when Jay was cuffed.
Big time cuffed.
Yeah, he was. But it was weird how we all had a lot of different work at the same time.
Yeah, you had a lot of things going on in your life.
It's just weird how we all kind of like got together and actually made it work. But that's a really good question.
A lot of people have met here. A lot of people meet at workplaces.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna try to get to these questions. That was a really good question, Melissa. Next question by Yahaira. She said she's also one of an OG fan. She said, "Is happiest a state of mind? How do you know you're actual happy or just surviving because your life isn't really miserable?"
Is happiest a state of mind? How do you know you're actually happy? Or just surviving because your life really isn't miserable. Damn.
I don't know.
I was going to say that. Ponder this question.
I think, I guess happy is a state of mind. I feel like you can't be happy all the time. And I'm not trying to be like a downer or whatever, but like you can't really be happy all the time just because life happens and we're humans and we have all sorts of emotions. We don't just have happy as an emotion. We also have sad, anger. We have all sorts of stuff. So, like, I feel like, I guess happy could be a state of mind, but it's not like
your state
of mind. Your state of mind, like forever. Right. Yeah.
I think happiest is a state of mind.
Yeah,
but that's a good answer.
I guess I don't know if I said it right at the beginning, but yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, definitely happy is a state of mind, and in a lot of ways, you get to choose your state of mind. I know it sounds
really shitty because
a lot of people go through things, and I've been there. I've been in dark places. I've been in low places, and like I want to not be obviously like sad or whatever,
mm-hmm.
and it's really hard to get out of it. But I think the more you work on yourself. Keeping yourself a lot like self-love, like working on yourself a lot, you are able to reach that a little bit easier, where you're happier just because, you know, just because you're alive, just because you appreciate that you're with your family, because you have a job, you have a house and all these things. You got to work on it though, but it's definitely a state of mind. I think so.
Yeah,
you got to work on it. It's not easy. I agree. But you can work on it and it can become that. But yeah. And what is the other one? Or just surviving because your life isn't really miserable? Oof. I mean.
Well, I think when it comes down to when we enjoy happy, it's because we were faced with sadness and all these other negative emotions. So I think that's.
It's like that saying, right? You got to go through a rainy day to appreciate the sunny days.
Yeah, to appreciate the rainbow and all that. Yeah.
So yeah. I mean, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Next question.
It's a good question. Great question. Yahaira. Yeah. All right, we're back. We took a little break. Where were we at?
We were on the last question.
The best life advice that we've received. And 1, 2, 3, go.
Don't take life too seriously.
Damn, I didn't.
That's like the very first one that just comes up to my mind.
I don't remember an advice, but that's a good one.
I mean, because if you really think about it, like a lot of times we take it so seriously where we have to do this, do that. And it gets very overwhelming, and then like it just kind of stops us from wanting to create or like actually live our lives. So right. If we take a step back and just kind of like take life a little bit more like ligero, then it's not like, or how do I say it in English? Like lightly, it's not that bad. Like if you start just realizing life is not that serious and you just kind of like just do whatever you want to do in life and just do it, get it done. That's kind of how I see it. I don't know. What do you guys think?
Shoot, boy. it's a lot of stuff to remember. I don't know.
What's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Just to be honest.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a very good one. Yeah, you might as well. It's true, though. I agree with that one a lot because a lot of times nowadays we're not very honest with people or with ourselves. And that plays a big issue with a lot of things. Like, you want to be able to try to be honest with yourself and
I'm not
with others.
I'm a human, bro. I've made mistakes. I've not been honest. I know that's some advice that I've gotten, and just I've not been honest on a lot of things in life. But I mean, I try to follow it. I try to, you know, learn from it, because I mean, some things that I've not been honest about,
backfired. Well,
yeah, it backfires. Everything comes out. Truth always comes out. You know what I mean? Closer. Truth always comes out, but you learn from it, and then you just, you know, move on. Another thing would be like just faith. You know, having faith, especially in like religion and stuff. You know, just don't lose your faith. I think that's right there. Like a lot of people, I don't know, a lot of people don't really believe in different or don't believe in religions at all. You know, they just think of different stuff. But one thing was just keep your faith strong and don't back down from it. That's one thing I've learned.
Yeah, I think a good one is just the golden rule, the most basic one, is you know do to others as like you would like them to do to you, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, you want to treat others like respectfully. You want to treat them nice. You want to treat them good, not just because obviously you want that good karma to get back to you, but just because you don't know what they're going through. You know, especially strangers.
Yeah.
Even friends, you still don't know what they're going through. You know, like if you see somebody like you be a dick to them, like you can only like let's just imagine that they're already having a shitty day or a shitty life. And you're over here just being a dick to them at Starbucks or being a dick to them on at the traffic. And you're just making their day even worse.
Yeah.
You know, you want to treat them good because you don't know what they're going through. And you want people to treat you good whenever you're not. I mean, at all times, obviously. But especially when you're going through some, you know, bad times. So I think, you know, that's a good one. That's a good one. You know, treat others as you would like to them do to you.
I agree. Facts. Yep. Big facts, bro.
I got one last question here. By Diana, she said, "What has been the toughest obstacle you guys have faced since y'all started?"
Oh man, consistency.
I know that one.
Bro. We've not been as consistent as we should have been.
It's the consistency. But behind that is just like us being able to
schedules.
Know. Yeah, the schedules.
It's schedules.
Well, that's
consistent. Like I said at the beginning. Actually, we cut it out.
Schedules.
I think we cut it out. But what I think, you know, is just like we're all adults. You know, like. We all have our own lives. We all have our own jobs. We all have our own things going on. And it's hard for us to, like, schedule the same day at the same time.
Right.
Especially, you know, because this is not, like, by all means, we're not making any money out of this. You know, we're just doing this for you guys and obviously for us and for the podcast. So it's hard to prioritize this sometimes. We try to as much as we can, but I think that's been by far the hardest one.
I think so, too.
Yeah, that's 100%. that's 100% the biggest thing that we've
But I think at the end of the day we at least we're trying to make some type of effort and keep going with it.
Yeah.
And,
another thing I don't know is content. Content's very hard to come by. I mean, too. You get too. This creative this it's like they call it writer's block on writers, yeah. But like on this is be like a creativity block. I don't know, but. You know,
after 100 episodes, like what can you
really,
talk about?
It's really hard. I know, as for instance, like the love languages, we've made about 3 or 4 different episodes based off I think there's 1 or 2, no?
Maybe 1.
I don't know,
maybe
but there's a few things sure that one.
we've brought
back because, I mean, not because we're running out of ideas or you know, content, but it's just hard, struggle. Especially within this last year. You know, we've all been kind of like, suffering a COVID pandemic and all this stuff.
I think it happens with any creative, any person that's a creator. You always run into these like creative blocks, I guess you could say. You forget. You kind of just feel like your mind is blank. You don't know what to talk about, what you don't want to do, or whatever. And it happens. I think it's kind of just part of being a human. So I would say that that's probably been one of the also another big struggle is having to do that. Along with the schedules, and I guess that's pretty much it, I'd say.
I think the main one has definitely been the schedules.
Yeah. Because I think a lot of times we just have a good time. Like, yeah. It doesn't matter what we talk about. We just come in here. I guess a lot of times we do these kind of episodes for, like, us in a way. Like, what we think is important for us. And, yeah, man. I think that's it, man. That would probably be it for the questions right now. Another thing that we wanted to... Go ahead and tell us, Julio. Let's go ahead. Oh, you guys, God. Go ahead and tell us. So you over the weekend or over the last week, you proposed.
Yeah, yeah.
So tell us,
bro.
Yeah.
So yeah, I've been dating my girlfriend.
Liz. Can you get a little bit closer to the mic?
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry, bro. You just don't sound like you're close to it.
So yeah, I've been dating my girlfriend for almost 13 years now. So we met when she was 14 and I was 15.
And that's when we started dating. So yeah, we've, like I said, we've been dating 12 years, almost 13. Mm-hmm. And, you know, after all this time, we decided, we both talked about it and we thought it was time. And I proposed and she said, yeah. But I mean, what I wanted to talk about was, honestly, I don't know if this felt for you, the same for you, Jason, but I feel like a new person almost. After, like,
it's another step, right?
It's almost like you step into a new level. It's kind of like when you graduate high school, then you graduate college, or like when you get a new car, or like a car for the first time. When you're like all these things, you feel like you're a new person almost. But yeah, I feel like a brand new man now. You know, I'm engaged. I feel like more responsibilities. Like my mentality changed a little bit. You know, like it changed a lot actually. Like, now I'm an engaged person. Like, now I'm looking towards the marriage and obviously towards the rest of my life, being married to this girl. It's not just all fun and games anymore. Now it's, like, more serious. It's still fun and games, but it's more serious. So I feel like almost, like, my mentality changed. I think for the good, obviously, but it did change. I don't know if that happened to you too, Jason.
Jason's like, fuck yeah, man.
Well, I don't know, man. It was different. It really was.
I mean, you but I've grown like a lot. Like when you proposed.
Yeah, it did change. It did change. It was a big. It really was a big change, but I still had to learn even in between, and I may have done a few things different, I know there's a few things that I should have done different within that time, but I mean, I can't go back and redo things like the way I did, but I mean. Yeah, I know what you're saying. There was like a different feeling, you know. It wasn't just wasn't just boyfriend and girlfriend anymore. Yeah, you know?
Maybe because it's also brand new to me because it's only been a week.
Yeah,
but I can definitely feel the difference. But anyways, I mean, it was great. I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed the whole process of planning the proposal and like doing it and surprising her with it. Jason just saw the video. Luis was there during the whole thing.
Bro, I mean, yeah, you went up. You did it, bro. That was a really good video. You know, I don't know what to say. Know
why. I just kind of thought like you were gonna high five, like.
Yeah, but it was really.
That
fun.
Was a good high five.
Yeah, that was a good one. It was a solid one. But it was really good, man. I feel really happy. I feel really excited. Yeah. It feels good, man. I feel like it was a good timing for us to do it too.
You do feel different. It does feel different though. It feels like it's like a good feeling. It's like it's like now that.
I'm proud of you guys. I can't wait to get to be in that little realm as well.
And you will be.
I know. But it feels good. I'm proud of you guys. You know, it feels good.
We're all in different stages, all of us.
Yeah, literally. Of course. Yeah. I'm not sweating it, but yeah.
But I mean, yeah, like I said,
enjoy it, bro. Enjoy the engagement.
Enjoy everything. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But like I said, man, I've really like enjoyed every step of it. And I think it's a perfect timing for a lot of reasons. Like I said, I don't want to get too personal into my life. But I think right now is a really good time for me to be engaged and to get married now. But it was really fun. It was really cool. The engagement, like, it took me a while to plan it. And luckily, Luis was there. Like, he got to be part of it. He got to the pictures and some other stuff. Yeah. He's been part of our relationship for a while. He's been taking pictures, like, photo shoots. Like,
not only that, just hanging out with you guys in general.
Just hanging out with us, too. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, I mean, he's been obviously our friend for a long time, and I always get him to do all of our photo shoots and stuff, and I was really happy for him to be part of the engagement planning too, but yeah,
it felt good.
It was great.
That's good. So you know what? Let's just do a quick cheers to that.
Cheers to that. Put him in.
Really.
Brocast him down.
It's not really no member down, bro.
I mean, I was just joking, bro. Sold her down.
Responsibilities would change.
Oh, I'm sure.
Mine was different.
That's another reason.
The difference between my engagement and yours is like my engagement was still it was still different. It's more different than yours because I was still long distance, mm-hmm. You know, and that's why I wish I could do things a little bit more different. I could have done things a little bit more differently because where we wasn't really able to see each other as much as we wanted to. Yeah, right? It was really hard. And, you know, it's just that distance, it affects things sometimes, you know?
Yeah.
But I mean, it's great now. Like, you know, 2 years down and, you know,
2 years married already?
2 years married and a lifetime to go. So, I mean, it's coming, you know, I mean, it's great.
What's some tips, bro? Give me some tips.
Just
some advice.
Be honest, bro.
Yeah, be honest.
Be patient. Patience is going to be a big thing. And just...
don't leave the toilet seat up all the way.
Yeah, bro. Make sure you keep that shit down.
Yeah, yeah.
Nah, but just be honest, patience, and understand. Just listen and you know.
Yeah. That's where that love language definitely come into play.
Yeah.
And just be considerate. You know, especially when you guys start living together. I don't know if y'all live together now or after y'all get married, you'll live together. Just, it's going to be a huge...
okay, this is a really good question. Do you think that people should should move in before they get married, or should they just get married after they get married? Like, should they move in after they get married?
That's a good question, because traditionally you're not supposed to.
Traditionally you're not supposed to.
Mexican household.
Yep. So now everything's changed.
I think personally, yeah, like,
Jason, you tell us, bro. You're married now.
Do you think live together.
I know. Okay, let me just set this up.
No.
Would you have changed things differently?
Let me just set it up real quick.
Okay, set it up.
Jason was dating Christina. It was long distance, but whatever. They weren't living together, obviously. They got engaged. They were not living together. They started living together after they got married.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So now, with you having gone through all that, and what do you think? Do you think people should live together a few months or maybe a year before they get married, or you think it's been working out?
Really... I'm a traditional type of dude, you know. I like to stick to traditional roots, right? It's really hard, because what I would say personally is obviously don't live together. But I mean, I can't tell everybody that, you know. I can't tell you that. It's just really hard because I don't know how to answer that, man. Because it's hard to say. I wouldn't live together. We didn't live together, so
yeah.
You know, we got married. We did everything that way, traditional way. So,
why does it make it feel so traditional though?
Does that
contradict with what you could have learned if you did live together?
Well, there was no. I think what happens is when you tend to live together, it's kind of playing. You know, you're playing house or whatever.
Yeah.
A lot of people are different though. They might not agree, but I don't really, I mean, that's just my opinion. And you're not really
well, I mean, it's,
I don't
really
know how to explain it, man.
Obviously,
I think I know what you're talking about.
You know what I'm saying?
If you get to live together before, it does help, because you
I would say it would help.
Yeah. Obviously, that's the obvious answer.
Well, but
you want to stick to tradition sometimes, you know,
Okay, I'm gonna be honest, man.
Chime in.
I'm not engaged. I'm not married. Nothing. I think I would want to live with somebody before I actually got married with them. That's just me, though.
But why?
I just to know how if we're compatible, because you know how people say that. That's when you really know.
That's a fair point.
So you think you need to live with somebody to know if you're compatible with that person?
I think you need to, but it helps.
I think it helps.
Okay,
it's like a preview of what you're gonna get if you do get married.
Obviously helps. Obviously,
but then then isn't that kind of down yourself in the beginning anyway?
Well, no, because
you're at that
we're
point.
Not really.
Well, hang on. You're at that point. You're like, well, I need to live with this person first to see if I'm compatible with for a lifetime.
I guess I'm not that traditional. In a way, I guess if I start to look at it what makes it so special about it being traditional? Just because everybody did it before?
It don't have to be traditional, but I'm just saying
what for you, in your case, you said you wanted to keep it traditional. What made it very special to keep it traditional? Just because everybody did it before you? Down the family line or?
No, it's just what I feel is morally right. You know what I mean?
Why does it make it morally right?
Just religion type of deal. You know what I mean?
Is that what religion says?
Well, I think it has a big... I don't know what it completely says, but I'm genuinely asking.
I don't know.
Okay, but yes. I'm just saying, as morally right, I think, you know, we shouldn't really live with that person unless you're married or whatever, but that's just what I believe.
Other thing is, though...
Do what you want.
Yeah, do what you want.
He's do what the fuck you want, man. I don't care what you do.
Yeah, do what you want. I don't really care what you do.
You're not going to move in with somebody. Just every girl.
I'm just saying, if you're living your relationship based off, I need to live with this person to see how it is first, then that's like, you're already down the relationship at that point. Why even
go to that point? That's a good point. Like, but at the same time, it's like, what if you don't really even know the person?
Well, you don't just move in with them after the, you know, obviously there's a dating period, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And a lot of relationships.
What if you don't know them? Like, what if you don't see, like, because, like, in some cases, you don't see who they really are until you're actually living with them. So they're not going to show that to you until you actually are there living with them every single day.
Yeah, but.
So, like, what about those kind of people?
Things change. You know, when we first moved in, like, after we got married, when we first moved in, it was shocking, like, to see how I live and how she lives, like. But of course, we communicate within the dating period.
Because you think some people,
what if it's a communication thing? Like, you have to talk to each other and ask these questions before you get married, before you moved in or whatever. So like these things, you should kind of already know. Like if that person's clean, I'm sure I've gone to her house when we were dating, and I just kind of picked up off her day to day life, and it was like, okay, so I kind of had an idea of how it was. But even after we moved in, it was a complete different story, but another you kind of adapt and you kind of help each other grow out of a lot of habits that you have, and then it just becomes like you really become one at that point.
Another important thing to point out again is that you guys were like a long distance relationship,
yeah.
So you didn't get to spend a lot of time together,
right?
So obviously, once you moved in together, then you were gonna see a lot of new things.
Yeah, we did. I saw a lot of new things.
Of course.
And she saw a lot of new things too. But it's
this shit hit different.
It's really, really.
It just depends. Honestly, let me just. It really depends on the person you're with. It depends on the specific situation. Like for me and Jason, like I feel like really opposite like experiences. You know, like how long did you date her?
3 years.
3 years, and it was a long distance relationship. Okay, it's working out great.
Mm-hmm.
It was a year and a half.
It was like almost 2 years, and then I proposed.
Okay, for me and my girlfriend, we dated for 13 years, pretty much, since I was 15, up until I was 28.
Right.
We dated, and we lived together. Well, not together. We lived close to each other. We spent a lot of time together all those 12 years. So I really got to know her family, the way she was, the way she grew up, the way the person she became to be. So like I got to know her really good. You knew your girlfriend at the time for like 2 years, let's just say.
Mm-hmm.
So it's two different scenarios. So what I'm saying is like every scenario is different.
Yeah. So maybe everything is different. Yeah, everyone's different.
Yeah.
So what took in your opinion, what made you wait that long? At what point, before you answer that, at what point in y'all's relationship did you know that you were going to marry her? Honestly, or you wanted to marry her?
Honestly?
Yeah.
But I was sounding corny?
Yeah, no, that's cool.
Right away.
So that's how I felt.
Right away.
Yeah, that's how I felt.
Right away. Like, literally when I was, like, 16, like, I knew. Maybe it was just in my head. Maybe I was just, like, being in love.
Yeah.
But right away, I knew that was the girl. Okay. I really did. I really, really did. The reason we waited is because we wanted to wait till we were like both stable, we were mature, we were both ready for this. Because we know marriage is not just like whatever thing.
Right.
If you think about
it sounds like you're pretty traditional.
Yes.
In a way too.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, for sure we are.
In a way that even though you guys dated for that long, like I said, in a way it doesn't really matter how long you guys dated. Only because you guys dated at a very early or a very young age. So really, if you think about it, like the mature stage where you're dating was probably only like half of that, probably. Yeah. Right. So like if you think about it, it's really not that long.
No.
Because you guys, because if you think about it, when you're dating at the early stage, you guys are young. You just got all of these are new feelings and everything. But then now once you start getting older and you're actually dating, then you start to really understand like each other's like flaws and everything that goes into it. So I don't think it's that long. I don't think.
Yeah.
You know, when you say 13 years, I think a lot of people say, damn, that's a long time. But like, right. You really think about it, like half of that was like, y'all were kids.
Yeah, we were kids.
Yeah, you were straight kids.
Yep. Yeah.
So.
But it worked out for us. It's working out for Jason.
And it would work out for anybody.
And it's going to work out for anybody. Yeah. You just have to find the right person. And if you want to go traditional and not live together or you want to.
So wait, what do you think you're going to do? You're going to.
I think you're going to go traditional.
Are you going to go super traditional and just wait until y'all get married?
Yeah.
To move together?
Yeah, 100%.
Now, is that Is that like a mutual decision, or is that more?
That's a mutual.
Mutual. That's what's up.
Pretty much everything we do is mutual.
That's what's up.
That's actually really interesting.
Who wears the pants in the relationship, bro?
You know, boy.
That's actually really congratulations. Yeah. You know, I wish you guys a long and prosperous, healthy relationship.
Yeah.
Marriage, especially. Yeah, it's different. It's hard. I'm telling you, man. Yeah, no. You'll piss each other off a lot.
Oh, for sure.
And shit will go down. Y'all fight. But
I mean, don't think that our 13 years of dating has been happily.
No. In our relationship, you know, we've had our ups and downs. You know, it happens.
I mean, you have to think about it. It happens. You know,
we're 16. I don't think a perfect relationship ever really truly exists.
No, I don't think so.
Because you know, there's two humans involved, right? And people make mistakes, or you know, not as far as in like bad mistakes, but as far as like. Everything you can, you know, people don't listen. People just it's just wild. You know,
I think you just gotta find people you're worth, like, just like worth. What's it called? And you just gotta find people that's worth like doing
your time
for.
I guess.
Yeah, because like you know, because you're gonna. I guess you can't be 100% perfect with somebody, so it's like you just gotta find somebody that's worth like doing all that with. You know.
Yeah. It's gonna be tough.
Yeah. It is. Yeah.
Even just the relationship.
It's fun. There's good. There's like just really there's fun times. General, there's sad times. There's scary times. There's a lot of times that you're gonna experience.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
But that's part of being alive, though. That's
yeah.
Part
but
of,
it's
like,
gonna be different whenever you're like when you're with that person. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like I don't know how to explain it. Like it is part of life. Everyone experiences
it's part of life.
It, but whenever you're not, it's not only you anymore. Then it's like, gosh, you know.
That sounds kind of fun and interesting, though.
Yeah.
Oh, it's fun.
Yeah.
It's fun, bro. It's fun. It's fun. Yeah. But yeah, that's it. That's it.
Anyway.
Anyways. And I know we talked about it. We don't have a lot of tequila left. We kind of drank it all.
That's
all right.
We don't need no more tequila, bro.
But so we're going to do like a truth or shot.
A truth or shot?
Yeah, you either say the truth or you take a shot. Just a quick thank you to everybody that... continues to listen to us and just to put up with our like craziness. I know we're kind of all over the place sometimes, and sometimes we'll do this, sometimes we'll do that, and at the end of the day, man, it feels good that people listen to us and that we have like a platform where we can do this kind of stuff and then just in a way kind of get drunk, maybe. I don't know, like we're not getting drunk.
Nah, we're catching a buzz.
It's just a buzz, man. We're catching a buzz. Damn, he's already pouring up the shots.
Yeah.
All right, pull up some...
Well, they're not really...
half shots?
Yeah, it's like this much.
We'll put it right here, though. Okay, really so we're going to do some trivia questions, and we either... you either looking up truth? Like
just trivia.
Look up like truth or dare.
Truth or dare?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like that way it's like more personal. That way like we have to either tell the truth or take a shot.
Okay.
Yeah.
No corny shit, bro.
AJ,
I'm just kidding.
When was your first kiss?
I was 13.
When was your first kiss, Jason?
I was like 13 or 14.
Really?
Yeah. First real kiss.
Who was it?
Don't kiss and tell, dog.
I just wanted to put him on the spot.
No.
Don't kiss and tell, bro.
I don't remember my first kiss.
I was nervous.
Were you?
I think everybody was nervous, no? Just a little old, young, chunky Jason, bro.
I don't remember my first kiss.
How?
Maybe it's the alcohol right now, but I can't remember for the love of...
You dog.
That don't...
I'm just kidding, bro.
You're the dog.
He's like, I'm not a dog. Meow.
Meow.
Damn.
I've heard some things about cats too. I've heard things that
like cats
people,
are
no. I've heard that if people don't like cats, then that means that they're very controlling. Because cats,
if
are,
you don't like cats,
yeah. Because
do you like cats?
I like cats. I don't mind them.
Okay,
but before we get to that, it's just because cats apparently they don't listen to you. They are very independent. They'll do what they want, right? So when you expect a cat to come up to you like a dog. To like give you the attention right away, and cats don't do that, and so some people that don't like cats, apparently there's some psychological thing behind that.
I never heard of that, but
we'll get into that later, I guess.
I can understand. I can see
that. Can you see that?
Yeah. Well,
because cats are very independent. They don't give a fuck.
Cats are just weird, bro. They're weird.
I like cats, though. I don't know if I could keep a cat as a pet, but I do like where they come from. Like, I like the fact that they come back from, like, this, like, they, like, that cat family where they're, like, tigers and all that, all those, like,
yeah,
cat family. Like, that's very interesting to me. But anyways, go on. Go, Jason. Julio.
First one's for Jason.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
You got to answer truthfully. Or take the shot.
Okay. That's
truthfully, cool. Jason. Here it is. What's the meanest thing you ever said to someone else?
Honestly, I don't know, man.
Shot.
Shot. Is it a shot though?
I mean, the meanest thing I've ever said to
you. Have to be honest. If you don't have anything, any truth, then you got to take the shot. Like, it's either truth or
really
shot.
Fucked up.
Huh?
It must be something really fucked up.
The meanest thing I've ever said to someone. Give me a second.
I probably said some mean shit before. No, so.
See, sure that's the thing.
I'm sure I have.
Can you think of something mean? I don't think I can. So do I have to take a shot?
I can't remember anything. I can't think of anything in specific.
Sounds like you
but
want to take the shot, bro.
Huh?
Sounds like you want to take the
I
shot.
I don't want to, but I guess. Like he already.
Did you see that? He's already like
going. Trying to play by the rules here. So
yeah.
Take the shot then.
Damn. I don't know, man. If I ever said anything mean to anybody, I'm sorry. All right. Well.
Take the shot, man.
Sorry, guys, to whoever. This is for you.
What's another question?
Let's see.
I feel like, before you even say anything, I just feel like you personally chose that one. Go on.
I'll try to find a good one. The other is like,
okay,
what's the weirdest thing you ever done on a plane? Come on, we don't want to know that. All right, here's the good one.
Oh, shit. All
right. Let me choose another one.
Just go for it, man. No, I don't care.
Just say it.
Okay, put me on the spot.
All right.
Shot. I'm just kidding.
Okay, number 50. Should I tell number 50?
Number 50?
No, I think that's too much. That's too much, right? Yeah. That's too much.
Yeah.
That's too much.
Nah, I can't say that.
Yeah, we'll go to a different one.
Immediately shot.
All right, here we go. Have you ever been nude in public? Public means not in the house. So outside of a house. You gotta tell us.
Well, where. Me and
you and Jason?
Me and Jason.
What?
We That came out wrong.
That came out horribly wrong.
That one time after prom, but we weren't fully nude.
Nobody was nude,
we
bro.
We weren't nude, but like, so that don't count. People are like, that one time after prom.
I didn't get nude.
You don't remember that one time we were streaking?
I know what y'all were talking about. No.
We didn't get nude. Like, we weren't nude. We were in our underwear. We were with, like, those people.
Talk.
Did you forget about that?
Dude, even I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
All right, so
nah, I don't remember that.
That's a shot, bro.
Is that a shot?
Unless you're gonna name names and plays, then
nah, bro. Let's name another.
I'll take the shot.
Yeah,
but,
you have to. But
have you ever been to a pub?
We were with other people. We weren't. It wasn't just me and Jason, by the way, because that shit got gay.
There were females involved.
God!
Just remember
asking. Damn.
Just remember number 50 for you, bro.
These are very, very, very hard, bro.
You just remember.
We can also think our own, too.
Yeah, I can think our own. Just remember asking number 50 for you.
What? I saw one.
What
is the biggest pet peeve that you have against the person on your right?
Oh.
That's not me? A
bad one. It's not bad. I mean.
Pet peeve.
Okay, wait, not pet peeve. What's the number one thing you dislike about the person on your right?
About me?
Yeah.
What right, the bro. Fuck?
Take a shot. No, I'm just kidding. No. Name another. Let's see. Because that's not... That's, okay. That's, yeah.
No, I want to know now.
You want to do another one?
You do whatever you want to do, man.
Gordon's like, fuck.
I mean, it's going to be... It's really easy. Really all right,
go for it.
Bad.
Go for it.
I probably think of something like easy to say.
Nah, I want to give you a hard one, bro.
I want to do a hard one, too.
Yeah, that's not an easy one. That was just jokingly. But he's like, but I really want to know. What's your biggest pet peeve against
If I think of something, it's going to be something like,
whatever. Okay, that one, I know that. I know what he would do on that one. I know exactly what he would do on that one, bro. He'd be a thotty.
Okay, so if you, if you switch genders, what was the first thing you would do?
I'd be a thotty.
He's like, come on, that nut. He's like,
So what are the options though? What are the options?
So I mean, if you it doesn't say options. It just says if you were if you switch genders, if you were a girl, what would be the first thing you do? Huh? Straight thotty?
Straight thotty, bro. Straight thotty.
Isn't that kind of gay though? I mean, I guess not because you're a girl, still, though, like, you're already thinking it. Weird, but you're thinking it from a male perspective.
Yeah, I'm thinking from a male
perspective. You're kind of gay.
Hey, I didn't say for the guys. Did I say with the guys?
I guess not. Okay, I guess not. Okay. Oh, man. So you're having a lesbian?
That's another question, bro. He's looking for another one.
I'm looking for another one.
Yeah, throw another one. Damn, this guy heated.
Ooh, that one's hard. That one, I can't ask him that one. 90.
Oh, wait, okay, let me, I'm gonna ask you a very personal one.
Okay. Go ahead.
I don't know. I'm trying to think, like, the way to...
Yeah, I'm asking, like, five questions.
This is not easy, bro.
It's because these are so easy, they're not even personal. I mean, they're personal, but they're not, like, that personal.
Okay, list one positive and negative thing about everybody in the room. Let's just go for that. Fuck it, I don't know.
Okay.
I can't think of anything. There'll be more. We got to keep it rolling.
Jason's the easiest one.
Okay. What's positive and negative?
Negative thing about you is you're negative about things.
Okay.
Oftenly.
No, I'm not.
That's negative.
Okay.
You look at the dark
I've been told I was negative about a few things, so it's not a problem.
He's logical.
Again, I'm realistic.
At least against towards
like, realistic, our logic, there we are. That's a better way.
You know, our way of thinking.
Right.
Positive thing is... you're funny.
Okay.
You're
cute.
You're cutie. You're funny.
Okay.
He's thick.
Is that it, bro? I'm just funny?
He's thick.
He's thick.
Damn.
No. You're funny, man. You know, you're like, you're hilarious. You're...
He's got that.
Bro, funny and hilarious are both in the same.
He's got that badonka donk.
No.
Curves come.
Okay, yeah, you're funny, man.
It's getting a little gay in here, dog.
You're down for things. You know, you're not like, let's do this. I don't want to. Recently, maybe. But before, you were always down for everything.
Yeah.
Okay. You're really nice. You're like, you're a really nice person. You have always good intentions. You're hardworking. You're a good friend. You're a loyal friend. Yeah. I feel like you're an honest guy. You stick to yourself, to your beliefs. You know, you don't let other people or other things or like trends persuade you. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Even though it. Okay.
Yeah. You are.
Bro, you could have just took the shot.
Just took the fucking shot.
Nah, I feel you. That's what's up, man. Damn. Okay.
You know, I'm keep going. Fuck you now, bro.
Yeah. Okay. No.
Another negative. Okay. Another negative.
I am negative.
Yeah, another negative about you. You are a full Republican.
Oh God, I think I'm a libertarian, bro. I think I play both sides on some things.
I'm just kidding,
but
bro.
Anyhow,
I'm kidding. All right.
Yeah, Trump 24.
Louise.
Save America. I'm fucking with you, bro. I'm just
kidding. Save America 2024.
Nah, man. All
right, Louise, a negative.
Damn, we're going straight to the negatives.
Yeah. I like to start with the negative, man, because then I go.
Yeah, because he can redeem himself with the positives.
Negative,
you know.
Honestly, we're very. I feel like in a lot of ways we're very alike. So I don't have a lot of negatives. I guess the only thing negative I guess I can think of is, I don't even know if it's a negative, but you get emotional about. Things
mm-hmm.
like passionate about things.
Oh yeah,
but it can be good. It can also be bad.
Yeah,
like it can take mm-hmm. you down. Like when we're arguing with Jason, it can take you down the rabbit hole, and like we're just like stuck on that. Okay. Positives. You're a fun person. You're fun.
I'd like to think I'm fun.
You're a fun guy. You're a fun guy. You're funny. You're really cool to hang out with. You're a good person to talk to. You know, like if I'm like if I want to talk to somebody about like some stuff, like deep stuff, like, you know, just random stuff, like you're the guy. Yeah. You're really positive, always a positive person. Like you always have
positive. This fucking guy. Me and this guy.
Hey, bro, I'm not gonna lie. I do get negative about some things, but I mean,
it oh, he said it.
Yeah, bro. I'm honest about it.
Yeah, that's a good thing about it.
Not in the heat of an argument, though.
Yeah.
Say what?
Not in the heat of an argument. You're like,
nah, dog.
Realistic.
Nah, but it is. A lot of things are realistic. But then again, like you said, you guys are very alike. So it's like, I'm fighting two people. So of course,
you're very talented. You're talented at a lot of things, like photography, like a bunch of things. You're talented. You're also talented, Jason.
Appreciate that, bro.
I don't know, man. Liar. Well, just really great friends. Let's move on.
Good answer, man.
Good answer.
Take the shot. I'm just kidding. All right, what's up?
Who's next?
Jason.
Me?
Yeah.
Round two.
You look for one. All right, let's look for one.
Just name one.
I kind of want to come up with one. Random.
All right, What's the last porn video you watched?
Whoa, bro. Your boy was young.
No, that was it. Two weeks ago, bro.
Oh man, it had to been. I want to say, lying, bro? I want to say it was
my ass, bro.
Dude, it's been a minute, bro.
It has not been a minute, Jason. You're lagging already. Take the shot.
I don't got no shots, bro.
You're lying, bro.
Okay, before
you know what,
switch the question. What was your what kind of videos did you watch?
Dog, what are we talking about here? I don't watch pornography, bro.
That's a big lie, bro. You have to answer honestly. We'll cut it out if you want to, but you can't be lying.
Nah, bro. Switch it up, dog. That's fucking weird, dog. Let me ask you, what porn did you watch as a kid, dog?
I would have took the shot.
It's just odd.
That's true.
I don't know, man.
You could have just took the shot.
You could have just took the shot.
It's fucking weird, dog.
Nah, we'll switch the question.
It's fucking weird, bro. Solo.
Wait, what? I don't get it. I don't get it. What happened? What is...
He answered.
Nah, that's a joke, dog.
Nah, that was not a joke, bro.
Let me pour me a shot, though.
Oh, man.
I will.
You said solo.
Yeah, it was a joke.
I don't get it.
It was just in the heat. It was awkward silence. Had to break it, bro.
But what does that mean?
He said what?
Just look it up, bro.
He said, what does it mean? Come on, bro. Throw me a question. Did you already finish yours?
Yeah, I took it last time.
Okay. Who's the last person you lurked on social media? You gotta answer honestly, bro.
I lurked on?
Oh, yeah. No. Who's the last person you had a crush on?
Oh, besides your wife.
Besides your wife.
Oh.
This was, you know.
The last person I had a crush on?
Yep.
Bro. Anyone, right?
Yeah. Ah, here we go. He's gonna be this celebrity.
Hey,
who was the?
No,
that's not the question.
No. The question is, who's the last person you had a crush on? Locally. Like that you knew, physically knew.
Yeah.
That physically knew.
And then knew you. I knew he was.
I don't know.
Okay.
All right, let's go for Luis. Man, this is getting intense.
You just gotta warm up. You just gotta warm up. That's what it is.
All right.
Damn, bro.
You go, Jason.
I like being on the spot, but at the same time, I don't like being on the spot because, like,
it gets too intense. Yeah.
But I guess people don't really care. They just want to see us, like, get vulnerable. But for us, it's like, it's a sense of, like, privacy, security. And it's just, like, putting all our stuff out there.
It's kind of wild, right?
Okay. Go for it.
If you had to sacrifice one person in your family.
Damn.
Okay. My brother.
Pato, you gotta fucking go.
Let me ask this.
I don't know what you're talking about. What is it? What?
Let me ask this. If you had to sacrifice 1% of your family to save all of them,
who would it be?
Besides you and your brother, because you and your brother are really close and it would be funny. Mm-hmm. Besides you and your brother.
My sister.
No, come on. I do it.
Okay.
I
mean, dude, okay. Wait.
Your parents.
As far, okay. As, let's.
If it was no cousins. Between them?
Yeah.
Or what?
Yeah,
he's gonna say his dad, obviously.
Damn, okay.
You had to sacrifice one of your aunts or uncles. Which one would it be?
Oh,
to save everyone.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one.
It's
hard.
Yeah, it's hard because, like, damn. I don't want to, like,
he's a fucks with all of them.
I'm just going to name somebody. Prime Tio Rey.
I don't know who that is, bro. It's on your dad's side?
It's on my dad's
side. Oh, damn.
He's a good guy, though. It's good. I hope he's not listening to this. He's going to be like, yo, what the fuck? I ain't taking no shot. I'm already feeling buzz right now.
Damn, okay. This guy's got some balls right here.
He's like, you're gonna take one for the team. Bro.
He's gonna have to just do it for the team, man.
Go ahead, hit me.
Okay, shit, man. I don't know, man. I don't know how personal we want to get now.
Go ahead, bro. I'll probably take the shot anyway. So,
all right, bro.
Nah, I don't want to. I just feel like the way that the direction is going with the episode, I feel like it's good. I don't want to know if we want to get dark. Just for like a game.
I don't want to get dark.
You don't have to answer. You can always take a shot, bro.
I guess so. I was just
I'm already two shots in, dude.
I was just gonna say, like,
for the record, the answers that I did give, they were jokes for sure.
Nah.
Yeah.
Nah.
Why would I take a shot? Nah. They really were. Whatever.
I was just gonna. I don't even know how I was gonna put it, but I was gonna. It had something to do with like if you ended up okay. So right now you're engaged, right?
Oh, you engaged
and all that, but. What if you ended up meeting the woman of your dreams?
I already met her.
Like, but like, what if you ended up meeting someone else? Kind of like the Netflix show, You. You know how You, like, he every time he meets somebody, he like completely falls in love, and he like wants to. He sees, like, he puts himself like obsessive, like, over this relationship.
He just, yeah.
And so, what if like you already engaged and everything, and, like, in the situation you're in now, but like. Like right now or tomorrow, you walk somewhere and you meet another girl of your dreams, and you're just so completely obsessed by this person. What would you do? Would you, like, if you're really in love with this person without even knowing them, like, are you willing to risk it all?
No.
Okay.
And no.
That's an easy question, bro. That's not very that hard.
I'm gonna tell you why though. Because I already made the commitment. Like, I'm already engaged. Like, I'm already in this.
Mm-hmm.
So, I wouldn't, like... No. I would stay where I'm at.
That's fucking easy, yeah, bro.
That's pretty easy. It didn't go dark.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess because you're just thinking of more realistically, but if you really put yourself in the situation where, like, you met this person, and, like, this person completely, like... Made you feel everything that you
made you question
feeling.
Everything.
It made you question everything.
But I've seen that story before.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't always plan out, you know.
It doesn't, but in your mind, it's not like that.
True.
In your mind, it's not like that at all. Your mind is like playing everything perfect.
I mean, if me right now, I wouldn't like.
Just because you're already on a high, you're like on the high horse, I guess.
Not just that, because like just where mentally I'm at right now, I wouldn't move it.
I just noticed your eyes are fucking red. Is this, are you
yeah. It's because he was crying about 15 minutes ago.
Oh, okay.
He was telling me how great of a person I was.
Well, yeah, that's good. That was a test, and you passed.
All right.
Let's take a shot, man. Let's take a fucking shot. Jason, pour one out, bro.
There's no more, bro.
There's no more.
But I got.
What do you mean there's no more?
Fuck it, we'll keep doing this, bro.
Cheers, guys.
I got a question. Why is it that when people shots, you know, they cheers and then they tap? Is it a superstitious thing?
No.
So what's the purpose of that?
Traditional.
I think it's just
I never learned that until I started hanging out with a bunch of different people, and they would always cheer.
I always try to tell.
I mean, how is it a respectful thing? I mean, who are you respecting at that point?
The table, you're
cheersing.
Don Patron, bro.
It's
already in the cup. You got to respect it enough to have it in your cup, right? So what's the point of it?
Because, man, this...
Nobody knows? You don't really know the real reason?
You're asking us the
yeah,
reason?
Yeah, what's the real reason why people... I don't know. They cheers and they tap.
What's the reason behind it?
I don't know. I'm asking you guys.
I don't know.
We try to have more fun than trying to be more serious in general, I'd say, right? But it honestly feels really good to be able to complete 100 episodes. Just because I never thought, like, we'd actually... Well, I guess I kind of had a feeling we'd make it here, but I never thought, like, we'd already be here, you know?
Yeah.
Like, we just... It kind of just happened out of nowhere or whatever. And so... It feels good. It feels good. It's a big milestone that we can actually like look back at and just be like, hell yeah, we completed 100, and hopefully we can make a lot more episodes, and hopefully the people that listen to us can, you know, stick around and listen to us all the way through. Eventually going to be doing what we want to do. Like, it would be nice to be able to do stuff for the people and like whatever they want. But at the end of the day, like, we're going to have to do what we want to do, because that's how, if we don't enjoy it, then we're not going to, like, stick around. So, like, we have to keep ourselves entertained within ourselves and do the things that we like to do. That way, like, we keep sticking around and being consistent, right?
Yeah.
Because if we start doing stuff for people and we don't really enjoy that, then it's just going to be like, oof. But that's not saying that we're not going to take any advice from anybody. Like, it'd be any feedback is good feedback.
You gotta still stick to your original idea, to yourselves. You know, don't let people mold you. You know, make yourself mold yourself. And stick to your thing. You know, if you started this for a certain reason, you know, stick to that. If you want to make a change in the world, stick to that. If you want to make people laugh, stick to that. Whatever you want to do, stick to it. And you're gonna get there. You don't need to let other people change your ways just to get the clout, just to get the numbers, just to get all that. You know, like, I would definitely say stick to yourselves.
I think so.
Big facts, bro.
And I mean, after 100 episodes, what I would just want to advise to other people is definitely go for it. You know, like, go try that thing, whatever it is that's holding you back. Like, just don't let that hold you back. Try it. If it's a YouTube channel, if it's a podcast, if it's whatever, it's like whatever it is. And we've talked about this before. Like, just don't let fear or don't let like all these things hold you back. Just go for it. It's definitely worth it.
I think it's worth it in the long run. Sometimes you don't see the results right away, but eventually once you do start to see them, it kind of makes you grateful for all the work that you did to get there. I think with all that being said, I think we can go ahead and talk about we wanted to do some merch. Mm-hmm. And we want to do more sweatshirts like we did in the past. Mm-hmm. I think we're going to go ahead and we already decided on design and everything. So we're just going to go ahead and put it on probably our Instagram page and maybe other platforms to just kind of start taking pre-orders for people that want to go ahead and order them. We do any size up to 2XL or whatever, or even 3X, I think. Regardless, not only are you guys just supporting the podcast, but it's something that we can do to provide people to show our so you can guys show the love, show support, show that you guys are repping us as well. And so it's a good thing. It's a win-win in both ways. And so we're gonna be sharing more information on that sweatshirt, so you guys can take a look at it. And you guys gotta, like, I don't know how long we're gonna keep it open to start taking pre-orders, but we wanna, you know, do it as soon as possible. So,
just follow us on the Instagram and you'll keep up with everything.
And if you guys don't have Instagram or don't use Instagram, then just, like, either hit us up directly. Get with the times, Grandpa. Or, you know, figure out another way.
Figure it out, bro.
You just got to figure it out. All right.
You can write us a
but
letter.
I think but the majority of people do follow us on the Instagram page. It's Brocast _.
Yeah, and if you don't follow us there, you have to follow at least one of us somewhere.
Somewhere. And if you don't follow us at all, then
why the fuck you listening?
I'm not just kidding. No. Anything else you guys want to say?
Just thank everybody. Thank you all for letting us, like, being here with us through 100 episodes means a lot.
It does mean a lot. It does mean a lot. And I think at this point, I'm kind of, like, sauce. So I'm just, like, I'm trying to, like, keep it
together, bro. Trying to keep it. Yeah. Nah, but yeah, thanks everybody. For 100 episodes. You know, appreciate the support. Keep supporting us, you know. We are very grateful for you guys.
So. 100 episodes. 100
episodes. He's out. Yeah, 100 more to go, so let's roll. Roll it, baby. Right.
I've been doing it for a long time. Bye, guys. Love you. Yeah, no friends in the industry. My brothers been my brothers. Man, you niggas ain't no kidding me. A fact. Whoa, I was known for snapping when I chat before the app. Stood on everything I said and never took it back. Whoa.